The woman comes, we try and ask, explain to her, what does she realize, why, how this happened, that she's not a bad woman because of it, because very often they feel very guilty for, I suppose, having lost their baby and then having lost their dignity and their normality, shall we say, or control over their own urine and feces. They feel very guilty, as if they were to blame.
This kind of women, when they come to the health facility, well, the first thing you see is that they are very depressed. They tend to sit on their own. And they don't like talking a lot with other people. They think they are the only ones who have this unfortunate situation. Added to that, when they are told the kind of procedure which is going to be carried out on them in African culture, surgery, the word surgery is something which is really threatening. First they say, will I die? They may not quite understand what they're being told, and they may not understand how this will help them, especially when they have all the traditional beliefs, myths and misconceptions. Having a service provider who really understands them, somebody who is empathetic to them, somebody who can listen to them, hear what happened to them, give them time to reflect on their feelings, explain to them that though this has occurred, there's still hope that it can be, their situation can return to normal. And even if it doesn't, they can still live their full life with some of the medical care that they can have. Makes a lot of difference to them.
You know, they need a proper tender love care. I think that's where some of them, we find that they don't have parents. When they come here, we sit together, you do the counseling with them, and at least they feel something that has been done, like a mother, what could be doing.
Most of them have lost their life companion, you might say, their husband or partner. And so they have to, I suppose they have to make themselves available and attractive again. That's another thing, to, you know, and dressing up is something that they have lost because it hasn't been worth it. And to give them that sense of self-worth, I think we'd work a lot on that, and to make them feel that they're so important again and that they have a place in society.
One of them is Rose. Rose has been even in the Dictor stories. Mm-hmm. After getting this problem, because she was a young lady in the new family, she was mistreated by the in-laws very badly. And finally, she came to know that they can do something. She could not even walk. She had feet drop. And Mother Winnie and colleagues, they did great work to keep her, to do all which was possible. She started walking. Then even the repair was done. God thinks she was successful. She was really at a dying point by the time she was brought in. And talking to her, you could see someone who has been, can I say, a resurrection from death, kind of, that she really cannot believe that I'm back again to my normal. Though she's really well, she even had the second pregnancy, she delivered her baby, the baby is lovely, and no, the husband is happy. They are staying together in a happy family once again. And you really felt that, God, there is great work.